A Palestinian terrorist stabbed a 38-year-old Israeli mother to death in her home near Hebron this weekend in front of her teenage daughter. In a separate incident today, a Palestinian stabbed a pregnant Israeli woman in the Judean community of Tekeo. Over the last 4 months, Palestinian terrorists have killed 29 Israelis and wounded nearly 300 more. As Chris Mitchell reports, an anxious public is wondering what's behind these attacks.
Throughout this wave of terror, security camera footage has documented the way Palestinians have attacked Israelis. Since September, they've carried out more than 100 stabbings, nearly 40 shootings, and more than 20 car ramming attacks. One way to protect people from the cars is these concrete-filled posts placed around bus stops like this one. Many wonder what's behind these indiscriminate attacks. One Israeli expert believes she knows what's behind the madness. Anat Berko is a criminologist, a lieutenant colonel in the reserves, and a member of Israel's Knesset. She spent years interviewing Palestinians, many of them women, who carried out terror attacks. While many blame what they call the oppression of Israel's occupation, Berko says it's often much more personal.
I found many cases that it was something that women tried to escape from, imposed marriage, incest, or things, problems inside the family, or try to just escape from the house. And many of them, I interviewed many women, and they told me we have much more freedom in the Israeli prison than in our houses.
Berko says the Islamic promise of paradise often drives these attacks.
It's to go to a place that is much better, Jannah. Jannah, which means paradise. It's like for the males, they'll have the 72 virgins. For the girls, she cannot say, as they told me, I cannot say, I want to have sex. So they are speaking about to be one of the virgins, and if she was married, she'll meet her husband. If was he was an abusive husband, he will go to Jahannam, to hell, and she'll go to paradise.
Berko sees a common thread in the terror attacks in Israel and the recent ones in San Bernardino, Paris, and Philadelphia.
But there is a problem right now that the West face, and they don't want to admit it, that there is something in this collective. I call it in my book, Shahada Mania. Shahada, it's the obsessive to carry out istishhad, self-sacrifice. Mm-hmm. And mania, you know what is mania?
Berko says in this battle, Israel and the West are on the same side.
Israel is the good side in this mm-hmm. equation. Mm-hmm. We are part of the West. We are the front line of the West. This is something that we need to stop and to know that in Paris, that in New York, and in Tel Aviv, and in Jerusalem, mm-hmm. the same enemy, the same phenomenon. Mm-hmm. And it's not about Israel, it's about all of us.
Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.